Now we are going to discuss how to find out place of supply of services, where location of supplier and recipient both are in India. This is governed under section 12, and section 12 make a list of various different type of supply of services, and for that various different methods of determining place of supply is been mentioned. And finally, there is a residual clause wherein if not following in any of the above cases, then place of supply will be so and so. So we will discuss now one by one such cases and finally the residual case. The first one, services directly in relation to an immovable property. So this is something relating to immovable property like land, building, etc. Including services provided by architects, interior decorators, surveyors, engineers, and other related experts or estate agents. Any services provided by way of grant of rights to use immovable property or for carrying out coordination of construction work. So if you see this list relating to immovable property, that architect, interior, surveyor, engineers, estate agents, or even letting of immovable property or carrying out coordination of construction work, that also is covered under this particular clause. What will be the place of supply? We will see. It is very logical, very simple. Second case is service of lodging accommodation by a hotel, guest house, or homestay, club, campsite, by whatever name called, and including a houseboat or any other vessel. So a service of lodging is provided or accommodation is provided in any hotel, guest house, whatever name you call it as, or even any particular vessel or boat like a cruise service, etc. So for this, what will be the place of supply of service? And service of accommodation in any immovable property. So in any immovable property, you have been accommodated for what? For organizing a marriage. So it can be a lawn given for marriage, or it can be a marriage hall, whatever it may be, or reception, or matters relating thereto, official, social, cultural, religious, business functions, including services provided in relation to such function at such property. So there is a hall, ceremony hall, wherein either the marriage or cultural or social or any official get together, any function is taking place, including services provided in relation to such function also. So if there is a catering service or say a service for event management, etc., is being provided for that particular event, then these services also covered. Why we are combining these three different services is because the logic for these three services is common and one and the same. So it will be easier for you to memorize. The first one is regarding property. Just imagine like a building, bungalow, land, building. What are all related services like architect, engineer, surveyor, interior decorators, etc. Second is about lodging. And third is about also accommodation. And in all three, it is related to a immovable property or a hotel or a immovable property like a lawn or a reception hall, etc. What will be the place of supply for this? Including any services ancillary to these services, means all the three above category of services are included. But if there is any allied services, associated ancillary services to this, that also will be covered. If not listed in this, that also will be covered. The location at which immovable property, that was discussed in the first case, or boat or vessel, that was discussed in the second case, is located or intended to be located. Now this intended to be located means what? If there is an architect or an interior decorator, a bungalow is not ready. It is going to be located in Mumbai, and for that he has to do some design. So It is located or intended to be located in Mumbai. That all is also covered. So in short, these are destination based of your immovable property. Immovable property or the vessel or the boat or the marriage lawn or the marriage hall, ceremony hall, wherever that particular property is located, that will become a place of supply of service. That is the place where services are being supplied. So it is quite logical, right? Now there is one more technical part for this. Property, if it is situated in India, then it will be such location. It means if it is the property for which the architect is doing providing his services is in Mumbai, so such property. Outside India, if property is located, then location of recipient. So if a person is going to construct a bungalow in Dubai and for that he has hired architect in Mumbai, then the property is outside India. So place of supply will not be outside India. Place of supply will be still location of the recipient, that is Mumbai. We will discuss these cases one by one. And third case is property in more than one state or union territory. So if that is the case, then proportion to the value of service separately collected or determined as per the contract, if there is any contract, and if there is no such contract, on the basis as may be prescribed, then by notification government will prescribe how to calculate this. So when a property is situated in more than one state, say you are constructing a road and for that road a surveyor or an engineer is been appointed, that road is passing through in two or three different states, then proportionate to the value of services separately collected or determined as per the contract will be applicable. We will discuss with examples, so it will be clear, just giving you the hint, right? So we will see now one by one the examples for this. The first one is, there is interior services for offices in Mumbai. Now one person is providing interior services. The office is situated in Mumbai. So obviously that is falling in the first category. And in first category, immovable property, wherever that is located, that will be the place of supply of the services. So place of supply of the services will be Mumbai. Second one, a guest house is in Dubai and it is owned by Mr. B of Pune, but it is used by A of Delhi for his personal use. Might be he has visited Dubai and he has asked Mr. B that I will stay at your guest house in Dubai, right? So what will be the place of supply of service? Now see this, very important. Since both the supplier and recipient are in India, right, and the property where the guest house is situated, the property is outside India. So if property is outside India, then location of the recipient of the service is very important. Who is receiving these services? Mr. A from Delhi is receiving the services. So location of receipt, that is place of supply of service, will be Delhi. This is very, very important. Provided supplier and recipient both are in India. This actually section 12 that we are discussing is actually related with both supplier and recipient. If they are in India, then and only in that case. So be very careful while determining this case. When property is situated outside India, then don't get confused that the place of supply will also be outside India. No, the place of supply will be the location of recipient. Who is receiving the services? A from Delhi, so location of recipient. An annual meeting of A Limited is held in the hotel in Delhi. A Limited is registered in Pune. So see, this is the third case. Services of accommodation in any immovable property, that is a hotel, there is a get together of or a business function, annual meeting of A Limited. So where that property is situated? The property is situated in Delhi, that is one, and that place is in India. So such location will be the place of supply of services. Site survey of road being constructed in Gujarat and Rajasthan. So a road is actually passing through two different states, Gujarat and Rajasthan. As per contract, it should be charged equally in both the states. So that site surveyor has said that my total fee will be 1,50,000 for Gujarat, 50,000 for Rajasthan. So place of supply will be equal in two states. So it will be 50,000 in Gujarat and 50,000 in Rajasthan, right? So you have to check now the place of supply is there. Now what is the place of supplier? Depending upon that, it will be decided whether it is an interstate or intrastate transaction. So if there is no agreement, then it will be decided as may be prescribed. So whenever a property is situated in more than one state or territory, it will be determined as per the contract in the same proportion. So let us discuss the next case now. Services of restaurant or catering services, personal grooming, fitness, beauty treatment, health services, including cosmetic or plastic surgery. Now, if you see in all these services, the common factor is the performance, where you are performing that activity, catering at a particular place, grooming, fitness, treatment, health, where you are performing. The location where services are actually performed. For all this, the location where the services are actually performed will become place of supply of services. So say for example, a beauty treatment services is taken in a beauty parlor at Mumbai. So where the performance of services is actually happening is in Mumbai. So place of supply of service will be here, same Mumbai. Next one, services in relation to training and performance appraisal. So these are kind of we can say any corporate training or performance appraisal is happening for in a company. Then if these services are provided to a registered person, location of such person, again if you can recollect, normally the logic is destination based tax, destination of the final recipient whom the services or goods are reaching finally up to. That location is important. So to a registered person, location of such person. And to an unregistered person, now you don't know a person, he is registered or not. Say for example, there is just a training program conducted for how to invest in share market. And it was an open invitation, open ad given in newspaper. So hundreds of people have gathered for that particular training program. You don't know whether they are registered or not, or rather all of them are not registered. So what will be the place of supply of services? Location where services are actually performed, because you are not able to know where ultimately the person, because he is not registered, is located. So take an example, corporate training services are conducted in Goa for A Limited. So A Limited has appointed one trainer and he said, okay, come to Goa, I will give you some training on how to manage the companies. And A Limited is registered at Mumbai. So place of supply of services will be location of registered person, that is Mumbai. Whereas corporate training services are conducted in Goa and Mr. A, who is unregistered, he also joined the training program. So see the difference now. For Mr. A, who is unregistered, the provision or sorry, the place of supply of service will be Goa, where the services are actually performed because A is unregistered.